Hello, this is a short primer on JSIM. There are many software for numerical simulation of ODE based models. JSIM is one of them. If you know any programming languages like C, Fortran, Python, you can write your own code to simulate a ODE based model. Visit JSIM webpage to download JSIM. If you are using Windows, please extract the downloaded file to a suitable location and then look for the jsim.batch file. Double click on that file to start JSIM. Before we use JSIM, let me explain how a code of a model works in JSIM. A JSIM code starts with the word math. Then you put the name of the model. For example, here I have given rev reaction because this is the model of the reversible reaction. Then you have to write down the rest of the model, the body of it. Note that the code block of JSIM remain inside a curly bracket. The first part of my code block deals with time. Here we have defined the initial time point t.min, that is the initial time point, the maximum time point, which is 12 here, and then t.delta, that represent the time interval at which JSIM will record the data. Then comes declaration of the parameter values and declaration of the dependent variable. In our model, we have two parameters, k1 and k2, those are defined, their values are declared, and then two dependent variables, a and b, are declared. Subsequently, we declare the initial condition, the value of a and b at t equal to 0, and finally, you write down the ODEs. This is a two-dimensional problem, so we have two ODEs, one for A, the other one for B. In JSIM, every statement ends with a semicolon. Don't miss it. Now, let us demonstrate JSIM. I have already downloaded JSIM and made a shortcut to jsim.batch file on my desktop. Let's double-click that shortcut to start JSIM. In JSIM, we put multiple codes together to make a project file. So in the file menu, you will get the option to open an existing project file, to create a new project, and to save files. Here, we are creating a new project. In a new project, I have to add models. Go to Add and go to New Model. Let me put a name to my new model. As it is a model for reversible reaction, let me name it RevRic. Now comes the tab for my model. In this white space, I can type my model. Rather, I will write down the code of the model. Something like this. But already I have written down the code in a text file and I have copied that. I'll simply paste it here. So now this is the code that I have discussed earlier is here in my JSIM. I have to compile it. Click compile. Once a successful compilation is done, the runtime tabs get activated. So here in runtime tab, you have control over the simulation. You can change the parameter values. We will not change anything. We will simply run it. Run is over. Now let me see the behavior of two variables A and B in a plot. So in this plot page tab, I can now plot my simulated data. I have two variables. Let me pull down and choose the first variable A. So this is the behavior of A as simulated by my model. In the vertical axis, I have A, concentration of A. In the horizontal axis, I have time. I have another variable B. I want to see the behavior of that variable also. So I'll add the second car and I will choose B for that. So now this is the data for B. Let me label the axis. So this is time. This one is concentration. Suppose I want to change the color of this red to green. If I want to change the color of black one for A to say blue. But if you want to draw this plot in some other software like Excel or Sigmaplot or MATLAB, you can actually take the COP data in numerical format. If you go to the text tab, you can see the data. You can copy it from here. But the best way is to go to File menu and export the data. There are many formats in which JSIM allows you to export the data in numerical with numerical values. So you can export the data and then use it for further analysis in some other software. Let me show you a very interesting capability of JSIM. Suppose I want to do multiple simulation of the same model by changing one particular parameter. For example, suppose I want to see how the K1, the value of K1 will affect the behavior of A. So I'll go to this loop tab. Here in the parameter, I'll choose K1. And I will choose certain multiple values of K1 to test. So I will start suppose with 0.2. Then the other values I will simulate is 0.3. Then comma suppose 0.4 comma 0.5. So I want 4 values of K1 for which 4 independent simulations will be run. And I want to see how the behavior of A changes with K1. To remove the clutter from this plot, I will switch off the graph for B because I don't want to see that. I want to only see the behavior of A with different values of K1. So now in this tab, I have K1 values given, 4 different values. I'll go to all run, click on loop run. Here comes my data for simulation of the model with different values of K1. This top one is for A when K1 is 0.2 and the lowest one is for A when K1 is 0.5. In this way, you can run many complicated simulations sequentially one after another and get the data all together, and then you can export it from export option here and analyze further. I have given you a short demonstration on how to use JSIM. Now let me leave you with a problem. I have shown a modified model for spread of infectious disease. In this model, we have considered that some of the people who are infected also get recovered. The rate constant for recovery is B. Now simulate this model using JSIM to understand the effect of B on the steady state size of the infected population. Numerical values for parameter R is 0.5. The initial condition is at t equal to 0, x is 0.02. So you have to run multiple simulation using JSIM for different values of B, and from that simulation you have to find out how the value of B is affecting the steady state value of X. Happy computing. See you in the next video.